Okay, I want to do a short little video here about the different Danish rolling block cartridges. There's like four of them. And I figured the easiest way to sort of explain them, or if you sort of want to look into it more yourself, it's easier than me just blabbing for like 20 minutes about them and boring the hell out of you. And if you aren't really interested, then you don't. If you're interested, you can go look, and it's all there. There's not a terrible lot of information about these cartridges, and it's sort of semi-confused because there's like four of them for the same gun. And I'm not that sure how, like, if they actually rechambered the guns when they went to the different ones, or the chamber was the same for them all. It's not a, unless somebody from Denmark knows, I can drop some comments down below or something. But so anyway, there's this website here. It's actually like a Spanish cartridge collecting association, and you can translate it on Google. It gets kind of weird sometimes when you translate it, but if you speak Spanish or read Spanish, it would be a lot probably easier to figure it out. But it's a really good website. It has all kinds of like center fire, rim fire, all kinds of different cartridge types. And you click on like center fire here, and then it has a big range of like diameters. So we'll go to say 11.4 to 19 millimeter. And you scroll down the list, and we'll start with, let's see here. We'll start with this one, because it links you to the other ones. 11.7 by 51 rimmed, or 51.6. They have all kinds of different names for them here. This is the cartridge that is probably the most common, that the Danish ones, Danish rolling blocks that you'll counter are chambered for. It's the one with the big, long, goofy sight, like on mine. And it's for the last one of the last cartridges that they chambered for when the military updated them to center fire. And it talks about it here. And it also gives you links. But we'll start with the rimfire, which... Rimfire Danis, 11.7 by 41. So that's this is the original cartridge that they were chambered for in 1867. Then... Danish like rifle association, I guess. What they created a center fire version of it, which according to this, it says model 1880, but I think they wrote before that, 1970s sometime. But this is basically the center fire version of the rim fire. It's a little bit longer. That's a good thing about this website. It has the pictures of the cases, has a few head stamps. There's a little bit of history. It's some of these weirder cartridges like this is not as pretty basic information, but you can take these cartridges and you can Google it and you can look. And there's other websites that are like cartridge collector websites that they get like the people that really know what they're talking about, and you can find more information about it. So they went from the rimfire to the sort of the centerfire one that was sort of a civilian or rifle club kind of, or target type round, I guess, or hunting round. And then when the military kind of decided they were going to replace the rolling block, they wanted to convert them all to center fire. And when they did that, they went to this one here, the 11.7 by 51. And you'll encounter those like lead bullets, or some of them have like a jacketed bullet. I'm not sure if that's because of the military conventions of the time. Everybody was going to jacketed stuff. But so they went to that. And then there's one other one you'll hear about. This is it's basically 11.7 by 40. It's like Greenland Hunter or something. You'll see it listed as, and this was, it gives you the blurb about it here, but this was like way after the guns were like horribly obsolete, like post-World War II, like in the 50s and 60s. They sent a bunch of these guns to Greenland, which is sort of like an autonomous territory of Denmark, and there was very little of the other ammo still around, or wasn't loaded anymore, like the 11.7 by 51, and the rimfire stuff being non-existent as well. So they wanted to make up the people in Greenland, or the stuff might have been made up in Denmark, but they wanted to make up cartridges. So they took 8 by 58 Danish Krag cartridges and cut them off, and you get a cartridge like this, which is quite short, but they did load it with smokeless by this time, I guess. You see her hunting in Greenland, and I guess we're hunting like mastodon or something, whatever they got there. Woolly rhinoceroses. So anyway, it's sort of semi-confused, all these different cars, like there's like four of them, but I guess they all go in the same gun. I'm not so sure what the chambers, if they change them. But some of these guns you'll encounter, they've been sort of reamed out a bit, so they'll take a full-length, like, 45-70 case, which, there's a lot of sort of misinformation that this Danish cartridge is the same as a 45-70, which is really not. It's, the base diameter is quite a lot bigger, and you can kind of get into trouble messing around with 45-70 cases sometimes, but, most of the brass, you gotta either make it out of, like, it's like 375 Holland flanged, or, there was some, I guess, made out of 348 by, like, Buffalo Arms or somebody, and there's some other cartridges I think you can make it out of. It's just that a lot of them, they're so much bigger here at the base that they'll swell up. At 45-70, they'll get bulged at the base and stuff, so it can become dangerous. But, and they're around 462. There's about, like, 11.7 is 460, but I don't know. A lot of European guns, that's bore diameter. I'll have to slug mine and find out what it is, or what my gun is anyway. But I think they kind of vary. Some are like 462, some are more, I guess. Some might be less, but anyway, so I'll post the link down below to this website. And you want to go in and waste a lot of time scrolling around here. There's all kinds of freaking cartridges, and you find ones you never even heard of, and sort of interesting little blurbs about them. So it has rimfire, centerfire, like a lot of really, really old cartridges, and, you know, modern stuff, and